What if we could screen for thousands of diseases all at once with just a single drop of blood? What if we could search out and destroy cancer cells without surgery or chemotherapy? What if we could restore eyesight by injecting tiny particles that help the body repair injured nerves? It may seem far-fetched, but they are goals of researchers working in the new medicine. But what is nanomedicine? Nanomedicine is the application technology to medicine.
Nanotechnology is the science of the small, the science and now, these days, also the engineering and applications of very small structures.
The giant game of Lego, only it is very small, and the building blocks are molecules and atoms.
In biology, most of the components of your cells and all of your proteins are all nanoscale objects.
So what doctors need are tiny tools that can work with fantastic precision at the nanoscale, the size of the smallest working part of our bodies.
Nanotechnology has created so many really unique and distinctive features, toolbox to try and address medical needs.
Think the drug to the right place. How do they avoid the biological barriers? These are problems that are very well suited for a solution that is a teamwork solution.
Hundreds of
researchers. La miniaturisation de plus en plus poussée des composants d'une industrie électronique, nano-électronique, stockant dans des volumes très faibles des puissances de traitement d'information bien plus grandes encore que maintenant, mais aussi mettre en œuvre, par exemple, l'utilisation biomédicale, une rétine artificielle, remplacer une oreille qui ne marche plus, avoir la possibilité de faire des fils moléculaires, par exemple un nerf qui arrive à stocker à toutes sortes d'impulsions. Et c'est décodé par le cerveau, ça c'est quelque chose. Les conséquences économiques et les conséquences sociétales seront très très grandes, il n'y a pas de doute.
Work on the nanoscale has already revolutionized research in Europe.
Das neue Konzept, das dort entwickelt worden ist, hat zum Inhalt nicht nur Forschung und Grundlagenforschung zu machen, sondern alle Disziplinen bis zum fertigen Produkt, das gesamte Engineering mit durchzuführen.
Like others, this research institute is already producing applications based on assembled molecules barely 10 nanometers long, nanoparticles. Here are a few little experiments demonstrating product efficiency before and after, just like the old hair. In this animated sequence, the tip, made up of atoms, is bathed in a blue glow linking it to the surface observed. This glow represents an exchange of electrons between the surface atoms and those forming the tip. On this scale, the atoms can swap electrons. This is what happens as the tip of the microscope moves. With a scanning microscope such as this, pictures on the screen do not represent light, but rather computation. They are actually a measurement of electron flow voltage and intensity, changing with every movement across the measured atoms. This provides a sort of relief map of the surface examined, atom by atom.
La distancia entre la punta y la muestra es del orden del nanómetro, se establece una corriente de electrones entre esa punta y esa muestra que no puede explicarse con los principios de la mecánica clásica de Newton, solamente puede explicarse con los principios de la mecánica clásica.
And here is a more detailed representation. Pushed by the tip of the tunnel effect mic moves, rubbing against the surface.
Material that in bundles of maybe a million or maybe much more than that, a million of these, you will have a material which is 100 times stronger than steel and 1/6 the weight.
Nanotubes look set to take over from the superannuated steel, but that's not all. Since they're perfect in less too, they'll certainly provide a major boost for the computer revolution.
Certain of these tubes are what we call ballistic conductors. They conduct without loss. They're not superconductors, but that means that whatever you put in this end gets to the other end. And that means that these incredibly thin sort of light wires could replace the copper wires, aluminium wires that we use today in transmitting electricity, and with zero loss.
Electrical contacts through the microscope.
Et voilà la barrette. Il y a trois encoches là, là et là. Ces trois encoches peuvent interagir avec des ions argent. L'argent, c'est un sel, c'est un solide, mais qu'on dissout dans un solvant. L'autre, la molécule, est un solide, mais qu'on dissout dans un solvant. On mélange les deux, puis ça se fait. Tout de suite, millisecondes, c'est fait. Par assemblage spontané.
Each of these circuits could spontaneously connect to similar circuits, increasing memory capacity.
Après tout, si la matière s'auto-organise, essayons de comprendre les mécanismes de cette auto-organisation. Et à partir des mécanismes d'auto-organisation, nous pouvons d'une part essayer de comprendre mieux l'origine de la vie, etc. Mais aussi mettre en œuvre ces auto-organisations et ces principes, ces concepts de base pour produire spontanément des structures d'une certaine nature, spontanément mais de façon tout à fait guérie, contrôlée.
Con la visión humana.
When the molecule, it is absorbed and the molecule's shape changes. As a result, a nerve impulse is sent to the brain. This is the visual process. At this point in the story, prospective nanoscience applications are appearing before your very eyes. Now we can dream of imminent and more long-term applications and note that nanotechnologies are already used today. To simplify, let's just say that each particle is positively charged so that they repel each other. Here's the lowdown. On the left is the magnetizable particle, on the right, an AIDS virus antibody. They bind together because of their positive and negative charges. If the virus is present, the antibody recognizes it and sticks to it. Then the magnetizable nanoparticle is extracted, still bound to the virus.
Allows researchers to build new tools that are actually smaller than cells, giving them the opportunity to attack cancer at the cellular and genetic level. This technology not only enables health practitioners to detect cancer earlier, but also holds the promise of stopping cancer before it even develops. This revolutionary approach be able to design a unique treatment for an individual's own medical and genetic profile. Based on computer chip technology, diagnostic devices such as nanoarrays are thousands of times more sensitive and accurate than current techniques. Because of their size, multiple lab tests can
do things like filtering much more efficiently. So you could filter water more effectively with more surface area.
Our ability to observe and change things at the nanoscale has led to a host